These are the stories I tell myself. These are the stories I tell. These are the stories I tell myself. These are the stories I tell myself. Let me tell you my story. During the pandemic, I really, really struggled with anxiety. I think everyone in some ways had their reckoning. And for me, a lot of it was the fact that I didn't come from a perfect home. My dad struggled with massive anxiety and developed an addiction to alcohol and anti-anxiety medicine. That lack of a father figure, it leaves a mark on you. And one of the first things that happens when you become a Christian is the starting point of your relationship with your earthly father becomes the starting point of your relationship with your heavenly father. And you end up projecting your idea of God based on your relationship with your dad onto God. So if your earthly father was distant, all of a sudden God is a distant person who maybe he loves you, maybe he's kind of tolerates you, but if you mess up, he's gonna put it to you. And those stories that you make up, that capacity, that sort of hijacking of your imagination towards self-destruction, it goes with you and you journey with it. It doesn't leave you unless you deal with it. And I found myself sort of at a place in the pandemic of after 15 years of not really touring and not really doing things as a Christian, but just being and homeschooling my kids because they couldn't go to school and being a dad and writing songs, but sort of once again realizing there were a lot of insecurities that I just needed to confront. And I did what I always do, which is I wrote a song about confronting those things. And the turning point for me, which it's always been, has been the reminding of my soul that the story of my life without God is hard to find meaning and purpose and context because it isn't perfect and it is full of hardship and it is full of painful moments. But the story of God that I found in the Bible is a story of grace. It's a story of redemption. It's a story of reconciliation, not working around pain, but working through it. And those are the stories now that I tell myself.